Coming up, I'll show how you can take advantage of the end-to-end full-stack monitoring, the advanced analytics, and the machine learning capabilities of Azure Monitor to find and fix any issue with the health and performance of your workload. Now, whether you're running complex workloads on Azure or embracing DevOps, you need that single monitoring tool that gives you a 360-degree view across your application code, infrastructure, and network, and allow teams and individuals to collaborate. With Azure Monitor, we have now consolidated the various monitoring tools in Azure to give you that holistic view of your application. You'll notice, for example, that Azure Log Analytics, the advanced analytics tool, and Azure Application Insights, the application performance monitoring tool, are now integrated into Azure Monitor. So how does Azure Monitor work? Azure Monitor collects telemetry in the form of metrics and logs from a number of sources. Some of them are Azure-specific, while others, such as operating system and application, are generic and is applicable for any workload running anywhere. In addition, you can inject your own custom data. The data is stored in centralized logs and metrics stores. These stores are fully managed and optimized for cost and performance. With all your monitoring data in one place, Azure Monitor provides end-to-end solutions that streamlines the monitoring workflow for canonical use cases, such as application performance monitoring, container, and VM monitoring. Instead of the end-to-end insights, you can just use the visualization and reporting features, or interact with the raw data using our advanced analytics platform. And you can enable automated alerts. You can also use our built-in integrations with ITSM tools like ServiceNow and other popular DevOps and SIEM tools, and you can also build your own custom integration. So all in all, you get an integrated experience with intelligent insights and full interoperability with your existing tools. So now that we understand how Azure Monitor works, let me walk you through an example of how you'll use Azure Monitor, and I'll point out some of the latest updates along the way. Let's start with alerts. Alerts are a good way to catch issues before they impact your customers, but an alert is only as good as the threshold you set. The right threshold should ideally catch any deviation from expected behavior, but knowing that expected behavior is sometimes not humanly possible. So how do we solve this? Let's take an example. Let's say you need to create an alert on CPU usage for a VM. Previously, I had to choose static threshold and provide an exact threshold value. That is difficult for patterns like this. Instead, now I can choose dynamic threshold, and Azure Monitor will use machine learning to automatically calculate the threshold for me at an hourly granularity. All that I need to do is choose how sensitive I want the threshold to be, and I can go create the alert. Instead of doing this individually for each and every VM, what I can do is update the alert rule and select all my VMs. I can also apply this alert rule to any VM that will be launched in the future in this resource group. So I now have a single alert rule that monitors the CPU usage across all my VMs, and I didn't even need to specify a threshold. Dynamic thresholds will also take into account factors such as seasonality, as you can see here. And of course, over time with more data, it keeps getting better. So we have made alerts better, and investigations are always easier if you have an alert as a starting point. But let's say you don't have any alerts, and your customers are complaining about intermittent performance problems. Let's look at the architecture of the app that your customers are complaining about. It's a simple three-tier app with a web tier, an API tier, and a database backend. There's also a Redis cache. The web and API tiers are running on VM scale sets. Although it's a simple app, if you open up the resource group, there are 16 different types of resources. So debugging a performance issue can feel like looking for a needle in a haystack. Thankfully, Azure Monitor can help you. I'm going to start with Application Insights and see if there are any issues with the code. The application map gives me a quick overview of the app, and I don't see any major issues. Let's look at the performance of the app over time. On an average, the request duration looks good, but at the 99th percentile, I see some delays. I can pick a request that took time, pick one of the samples, and see the end-to-end trace. It looks like the API tier is taking time, but again, I don't see any issues with the code. That leads me to think that this is an infrastructure issue, and based on the tracing here, my hypothesis is that the API tier is the culprit. So how do we debug an infrastructure issue with Azure Monitor? So with integrated monitoring, I can see all the metrics from different components of the API tier in one place. I want to look at virtual machines. And given Azure Monitor has an end-to-end solution for virtual machines, I'm going to go there. You'll see a lot of similarities here with the application debug experience. Similar to the app map, we have a VM map. It's a quick way to rule out any latency or communication issues. I can click on health, and it tells me that there aren't any health issues either. I can flip to performance. I see some CPU spikes with one of the VMs that's running my API tier. So my theory is that the intermittent CPU spike in one of the VMs in the API tier is causing the performance problems with the application. But how do I prove it? This is where the common log store and advanced log analytics comes into play. One thing to note is that this log store is used not just for monitoring. It's used by a number of other tools such as Azure Security Center and Azure Sentinel. So you get to see all your security and operational data in one place, which is very helpful in a situation like ours, where we need to correlate data from multiple sources to prove a hypothesis. To interact with the data, I'm going to use a query language called Gusto Query Language, or KQL. What I'm going to do is that for that particular VM that I think has an issue, I'm going to overlay the app request duration with the CPU usage and see if there are any patterns. You can see that there's a near perfect correlation between the CPU spikes and the spike in request duration. It is to the point where I think we can safely establish causation. The next step is to figure out what was causing the CPU spike. Again, with integrated monitoring, I have all the data right here. So I'm going to run a KQL query that shows the CPU usage by process on that particular VM. And I can see that the process stress is the culprit. So it looks like there's a stress test that is kicking off intermittently on this particular VM that is causing all these problems. How do we fix this? Given that the VM has been running for a while and I don't know what else is wrong with it, I'm hesitant to disable the process. Since this VM is on a VM scale set, I can just delete the VM and let VM scale set launch a new VM on its behalf. I have automation in place to deploy the code to the new VM before it gets added to the load balancer. So in this example, we were able to traverse the entire application stack from the code to the infrastructure, use analytics to find the root cause, and resolve the issue without ever leaving the Azure portal. This is the benefit of the integrated experience and intelligent insights you get with Azure Monitor. But what if you are not using VMs and using containers instead? We have Azure Monitor for containers that gives you integrated monitoring for Azure Kubernetes Service or AKS clusters, and some powerful tools to help you troubleshoot issues, again, without ever having to log into the container. We recently added support for Windows Server containers, and for monitored clusters, you can see a lot of information, including the CPU and memory usage at a cluster, node, controller, and down to the container level. You can see and interact with live logs for containers, and we recently added the ability to view live Kubernetes events. And if you want to see the log data and run detailed queries, you can always use log analytics. So you may also be wondering how to onboard your resources to Azure Monitor. Azure Monitor provides native monitoring for Azure, which means that for most Azure resources, you get out-of-the-box telemetry without any instrumentation. For certain resources such as VMs and containers and your application, you may want to get additional telemetry and capture detailed logs. To learn more about onboarding such resources, check the following links. We hope that you start using Azure Monitor today. Thanks for watching.